So in my last video you have seen how we have applied the properties of logarithm in case of differentiation. There in my last video I have chosen two different questions. In this video I have taken another two questions, how to apply the properties of logarithm in such type of questions. Okay, so let us move and watch the video. Understood? So in case of log m minus n, we don't have such property that we can write log m minus log n. After this we cannot proceed. So directly we cannot take logarithm now. Okay, for that what we have to do, we have to take again, we have to suppose again both the functions separately. Also let u equal to x to the power x, we can take logarithm both sides, log u, because it is a function to the power function, so log x to the power x. What we have done, taking, then log u, this will become x log x, so x log x d by dx of log x plus log x d by dx of x is equal to x, the dx of log x is 1 by x plus d by dx of x is 1, so 1 into log x means log x. Okay, x x cancels, so 1 plus log x, y will cross multiply to this side, 1 plus log x. Question number 9. Now u equal to x to the power sine x, so function to the power function, so function to the power function, that means we have to take logarithm. Therefore, dv by dx equal to v into this part, v into this part. Okay, then we will replace v. So v is what? V is sine x whole to the power cos x into this. Then you put dy by dx